ISUPK.
Shalom Israel. We are the ISUPK out of One West, 121st Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yohana. Since 1969, we have been teaching that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of Israel.
What?
I come out here today because I want to know why black people voted. Black people have been voting since Eric Williams, and black people is always at the bottom.
Right.
So why is black people voting? We voted PNM and UNC, and the black man is always suffering. So why all of voting? Voting don't make sense once it's a black person.
Right.
Voting only makes sense if it's a East Indian.
Right.
Because it's only the East Indians growing up. Them own any bank. The 1% running Mario's and KFC.
Right.
It's only them alone prospering. But black man, no matter who you vote for, you will always be at the bottom.
The book of Deuteronomy 17 and verse 15. Thou in any wise set him king over thee, whom the Lord thy God shall choose.
Right. So the Bible says to do not vote. If it's a black man, the Bible says to do not vote.
Right.
No matter who black people vote for, we always suffer. You understand? Black people is always selling drugs. Because it's the politicians who are bringing in the drugs in the black community in the first place. It's the politicians who are bringing in the guns in the black community in the first place.
Right.
So why black people voting? And is the politicians what killing black people?
Right.
No black person should vote. Leave the PLM and UNC alone. Once you vote and there's a black man, you go always suffer.
Right.
Because politicians don't give a damn about black people.
Right.
You ever hear any politician tell a black man come and get a Italian? Which politician? Tell a black man come and get an acre land, or come and get $1 million, or you can go in the bank, black man, and you'll get a loan for 200 million. No politician gives a damn about black people,
right.
But we still voted. It's only the East Indians prospering over politics. The Chinese prospering over politics.
Right.
Black people not prospering of our politics.
Right, right.
So why black people voting? It makes no sense if there's a black person and voting, because you go always be at the bottom of the table. Why they don't fix Silas and John John? Because no black person gives a damn. No black politician gives a damn about black people. Once you go into office, they only care about the East Indians.
Right.
That is all they care about. But we still voting.
Right.
You know why? Because we still slaves. We still living in those days where we feel that, hey, one day, somebody's going to save us. Somebody's going to save black people from suffering.
Right.
But politicians cannot save black people.
Right.
No matter who we vote for, no politician could ever save a black person. None. All it is do is use black people. Use our oppression against us.
Right.
When the East Indians went up the ladder. and black people only go and dog. There's the politicians don't care about we. And we just read in the Bible, God said Christ would be black people's king.
Right.
Because Christ is a black man and he's our king over us. We shouldn't put nobody else to be ruling over us but Christ.
Deuteronomy chapter 17 and verse 15. Thou, in any wise, set him king over thee.
Right, so thou, in any wise, you will put somebody king over you. That is what the Bible says.
Well, whom the Lord thy God shall choose.
Whom the Lord thy God shall choose. God is choosing Christ to be black people's king over us. The Lord don't choose Rowley to be over black people. The Lord don't choose Kamala to be over black people. Because why? Years before PNM and UNC, and look how much vagrants on the streets. It's black people.
Right.
Politicians don't care about black people. So why we voting? It do not make sense for a black person to vote.
Right.
Because we always suffer.
Right.
No matter who we vote for.
Right.
So why all of voting? You understand? It doesn't make sense if it's a black person to vote. Let the Chinese and the Indians vote. They say we have free education, but that is a damn lie. Free education does not exist if there's a poor black man. That is a damn lie. You understand? The Indians have free education. Because why? When you had to pay to sign up for class, poor black people don't have money to even sign up to go to school. It's our poor black people. Don't even have money to travel, to take a taxi, to go to school. Once you're poor and you're black, no politician gives a damn about you. The only time the politicians care about you is if you're an East Indian. That's the only time them politicians care about you. Only if you're an East Indian. So why all of voting? You understand? All of should not vote because Christ would be our king of us.
Right.
No matter who the black man vote for, we always suffer.
Right.
We always suffer.
Right.
You understand? No politician gives a damn about black people.
Right.
They're just using us to get a vote. When they get in office, that is it. They show we aside. You understand? And it's only black people alone they're using. Because that is the only race that they could use.
Right.
They see a race destroyed and oppressed. The East Indians not destroyed and oppressed.
Right.
So the politicians not using East Indians. The politicians using black people. They see a race what destroyed and oppressed. And if they give them $100, they can do anything that they say to do. So the East Indians and them using black people to get votes. When they get in office, nothing for the black man. Both PNM and UNC don't give a damn about black people. All they just want to do is to put guns and drugs in the black community and make we kill each other like dogs. So why we voting? Yeah? Voting don't mean nothing. But don't worry, black man. A war is coming. A war is coming very soon, black man. And it's time all us separate from politics. All us separate from them East Indians. Separate from the Chinese black man.
Right.
Because a war is coming very soon.
Right.
All us see what went on in Lebanon the other day. You understand? They say it's fireworks. I never see fireworks girl like that before. But a war is coming very soon, black man.
Right.
World War III is coming soon.
Right.
And it is prophesied in the Bible.
Right.
And if all you stop voting, then all you will not feel the wrath of World War III, black man.
Right.
But if all you continue to vote, when Christ return and the fire and bombs, the nuclear weapons come, all you going to feel the wrath.
Ecclesiastes 3 and 8. A time to love, a time to hate, a time of war, a time of peace.
The Bible says there's a time for war. Right now is the time for war, black man.
Right.
You understand? A war is coming very soon, black man. And all of you to separate from all them other races that oppressing blacks and Hispanic people. You understand? The Venezuelans come across here, them suffering and they oppress.
Right.
But the East Indians making a war among the Venezuelans and black people. You understand? The Venezuelans is good people. You understand? So white is all I want to send them back to Venezuela.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 8. A time to love. And a time to hate.
There's a time to love, black man. There's a time to hate. Right now is the time to love each other, black man. Love the Venezuelans, black man. Because the Venezuelans is black people. They came from the same West Coast Africa in slavery. You understand? It don't matter the lighter skin complexion. The Venezuelans is black people. And you have to love the Venezuelans.
Right.
You understand? Wherever you see a Venezuelan black man, love the Venezuelans.
Right.
You understand? Love every black person, Silas and John John.
Right.
You understand? That's what we should do. Love every black man in Chumaka, Plavantil.
Right.
In Caledonia, every black person should love each other.
Right.
A time of war and a time of peace.
But this war is a spiritual war, black man.
Right.
What we have to do is separate ourselves
right.
from all them races.
Right.
Separate ourselves from politics. We come back together as a black community, all blacks and Hispanics.
Right.
Build we community and then we get we own bus station. We own airports. And black businesses, black
right.
hospitals. That is what black people should be doing. And not voting PNM and UNC. PNM and UNC don't give a damn about black people.
Right.
So all of should stop vote.
Right.
Rowley and Cannon hate black people. So why all of voting? Look how much are vagrants on the streets. Which political party ever help them black people on the streets? None. But let's still voting.
Joel chapter 3 and verse 1. For behold, in those days, in that time, when I shall bring against the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem.
Right? Let's talk about this time that we're living in, right? We're living in captivity right now. Right now, all blacks, Hispanics living in captivity. The Venezuelans is black people. Them is Indians, not black. The Venezuelans black. Them is our brothers and sisters.
Right.
When all of us see a Venezuelan, love the Venezuelan. You don't have to love them racist Indians. Let me say, don't love black people. But if you see a Venezuelan, love the Venezuelan. Because them went into slavery the same way as you black man went into slavery.
Verse 2. I will also gather all nations and bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
Right? The Lord says he's going to bring all nations. Your nation is a race. Them East Indian nation is in India. You understand? Our nation, blacks, Hispanics, and native Indians. Our nation is really in Jerusalem, the Middle East. You understand? All nations, the Arabs, all nations going to go into the Middle East and fight each other. That is World War III. That is what's going to happen. All races going to go into that Middle East and fight each other. That is World War III.
And will plead with them, therefore, my people, and for my heritage, Israel.
And will plead with them there. Do you all know how the Lord pleads with people? After the Lord gives you a beating, that is how we just plead with you. By giving you a beating. When you fed up at that beating, you have so much of destruction, so much plague, so much diseases and sickness. That is when you say, all right, the Lord, I had enough. That is when the Lord pleaded with you. The Lord don't come and say, oh, I'm talking to you nice and tell you, all right, stop what you're doing now. That is not pleading. The Lord pleading is when he gives you a good beating till you can't handle it. You find it's too much. You get a broken hand, a broken foot. And they say, all right, Lord, I had enough. I will submit to you. You understand? That is what the Lord talks about when he pleads with you.
Go ahead. Whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land. Verse 3. And they have cast lots for my people.
right? And they have cast lots to my people. So it's like they're auctioning us, they're gambling us away. They're casting lots to his people, shaking dice and whatever. Cast lots. You understand? The person auction sale, when they just bid them, many people talking fast and saying $100 going $200, you understand? Gambling us, all kind of thing, great.
And I've given a boy for an addict.
Right, right.
And sold a girl for wine.
Right, so they turn us into whores, prostitutes, homosexuals, that's what they do. Giving a boy for a lot. Right.
That day, my drink. With four, yeah, and what have you to do with me, for Tariq and Zidane?
So what have you to do with the Lord, O Tyree and Zidon? Tyree and Zidon is a famous or a rich African port. You know how it's a Port of Spain? Port of Spain is a port, it's a famous port. Tyree and Zidon was a famous African port in Africa. So the Lord is saying, what have you to do with me? How would you repay me, African, for selling them the children of Israel into slavery? That when the Lord said, what power you repay me? Right?
And all the courts of the Philistines, will you render me a recompense?
Right? How will you repay me? Right?
And if you recompense me swiftly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your own head?
Right? So if you repay the Lord has said he's going to repay your recompense upon your own head. He's going to repay you. World War III is coming, black man. You understand? And this Bible was only written for black people, Hispanic and Native Indian.
Yeah. Because you have taken my silver and my gold and have carried into your temples my godly pleasant things.
Right, you have taken my silver and gold. Those hills take a lot of our treasures to build up over there, how it is so rich now, the Middle East. And on top of that, we are silver and gold to the Lord. All blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. We is diamond and gold. You understand? And they took us and enslaved us and sold us to the white man. Well.
Verse 6, the children also of Judah and the children of Jerusalem have you sold unto the Grecians.
Right? So the Africans sold us, the children of Israel, unto the white man,
right,
who is the Christian. That is what the Bible says. We are not sinking African, that is a lie. You understand? The white man lied to us about everything. And we're walking around like slaves today now, believing everything the slave master taught us. We is not no African. Where's the proof that we is African? It has no proof that we is African. We is Hebrew Israelites according to the Bible.
Trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I'm believing fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord?